My research focuses on how can we make electric cars and batteries better so that we can decarbonize transport and other forms of electricity use. Climate change is happening, and it's closely related to the carbon dioxide that we produce, and that can come from a number of sources. One of the main ones is transport. So one of the key goals of our research is to increase the energy density, and that's how much energy you have per kilogram of batteries that you carry around. What that means is that your electric car will be able to drive further, and it will be cheaper as well. You know, one of the really exciting developments is that of solid-state batteries. And that's a technology which allows us to double or triple the energy density of a battery, which really solves the problem of range anxiety for electric vehicles. It really unlocks the capability to electrify other modes of transport. So to put it into context, if you did one long-haul flight every year, say from London to Hong Kong and back, that's equivalent to leaving a 3 kilowatt kettle on for an entire year. Right now, lithium-ion battery technology, you can't really electrify long-haul flight. But if we have a solid-state battery, all of a sudden that changes the equation, and it really starts to make us rethink what is possible with this technology. When we take a holistic look on both the transport sector and the energy system, we can see loads of room for opportunity to decarbonize the system, and hopefully energy storage technologies like batteries and also hydrogen has a huge role to help us enable that path to zero carbon. We want our work to reduce CO2 emissions, create jobs, and be sustainable in the long term. I'm quite optimistic about the future. If we look at the technologies and the improvements that have been made there, such as battery cost and lifetime, these have made significant progress in the last few years, and I can only see that improving in the next few years to come.